Hey everyone, so how's everybody today? And so today it's Sunday, March 25th, 2018. It's just past 1 o'clock and having a lazy weekend because I got the weekend off. And yesterday for Saturday, I did absolutely nothing. And so since Friday, when I got home Friday night before 9 o'clock p.m. until now, I've been at home the whole time for the whole 24 hours plus and done nothing, absolutely nothing at all. And I decided to go out for a little bit stretch now. And I was a little bit annoyed this morning because I was wanting my travel agent to book my excursions for me, but then she said I can go on the website myself to book it, but then I find the Norwegian Cruise Line, the website, to be so confusing to use, and I am not impressed by it at all. So I was calling their 1-800 phone number to book my excursions, because now I am traveling by myself and big boy traveling by myself, and so I gotta look at all the details by myself because I do not want to go to the ship and then the excursions are all sold out and there's nothing for me to do for 15 days. That'll be pretty boring. And also because when you book the excursions, if you book now, you pay in Canadian dollars now. And if you book at the cruise ship, it's gonna be whatever the exchange rate is for that time. So it's gonna be better to book now. And I was on the damn phone waiting, just waiting, and almost half an hour this morning. This drives me mad, and seems to be a busy ship because a lot of the stuff that I wanted to do, the excursions was all sold out. And so, yeah, most of the excursions was all sold out, and because the places that the cruise ship is going, I've never been to any of them before, so I am doing an excursion at every port, which is a total of 5 ports, so it's not too bad. But I spent another almost $600 for the excursions, and the annoying thing about Norwegian is if you want to book for the shows and stuff, you have to call another number for that, and I just don't want to deal with that shit today. And so I am gonna be on that ship for 15 days, so I am sure that I'm gonna be able to squeeze in the shows. And the main show that I want to see is the Blue Man Group, because they have the Blue Man Group on the ship. And when me and my ex went to Vegas last time, we did not see them because we were broke that time. So now I finally get a chance to see the Blue Man Group. So the first things first I'm gonna do when I get on the ship is gonna book tickets for the Blue Man Group. So that is what I'm going to do for sure. And the rest is all history, and can just let the rest of the trip unfold by itself. So yeah, so I booked my excursions and I'm like $600 down the hole. But yeah, it's gonna be worth it. It's my first single traveler trip, and I do everything myself. I pay everything myself, and We will see how my planning goes. Haha, gonna see about that. But I'm sure it's gonna be fine. Yeah, so right now I'm just taking a look to see where to go for lunch. And I'll be back in a bit, guys. I do have a confession to make though. It's like, I really wanted to go to the gym this weekend, but I don't know if it's because the weather is changing or something, but it's like my knee was just so sore on the weekend. I thought I was gonna die this weekend because it was so bad. So I am deciding what I want to do for lunch. Cause I am in the mood for something Hong Kong style cafe something. Cause I haven't done that for a long time. So yeah, but about the gym time thing, maybe next week sometime. There's always a next week, right guys? I'll see what I come up with for lunch. This is what I'm talking about. BBQ. Huh? May lam gan chong. Got it. Oh my gosh, you guys, like, I am having such a good day today, and so I discovered this restaurant, and well, it's not new, it's been around for a while, but just never made my way to check it out, and really, really nice lunch, and they had a special combo, a lunch combo, and they include you the meal, the soup, and the hot tea or hot coffee. Really, really good deal. And I'm gonna be coming back to check out the other days. Ooh. Because they have the daily specials. And then underneath the restaurant is a bakery, and I went to the bakery. And Hong Kong style bakery, and they just had some fresh egg tarts, and I haven't had those in a while, so I bought me some egg tarts. Oh my gosh, I am being a Mr. Fat today. And so yeah, the restaurant was really, really nice. And so now I might be a super duper fatty, and I might be going to bubble tea, and I want to see any of the optical places in Chinatown here to maybe look at some glasses. So that is what I'm doing today. The optical place is open on a Sunday. Is it open? I'll have a look. Hey guys, so it's just gonna be a really, really short day today, and the bubble tea place that I like, they are closed for vacation, and the eyeglasses place has nothing, and I discovered this candy store. They sell all of these unique flavors of Kit Kat, but I spoke Chinese to the guy, the store owner, and it's like, the guy is like, the flavors are not for sale yet. Want to sell the other stuff first. It's like, really? And so I guess it's better for my wallet if the guy is not willing to sell it. It's like, they got flavors like Japanese wine or sake flavor Kit Kats, and they got a apple flavor Kit Kat, and they got like cantaloupe flavor Kit Kat. They got whole lot of them. It's like, yeah, but the guy says they are not ready for sale yet, so be it then. I just got my fatty Chinese bakery stuff for the day, so that would be my damage done for the day. And so yeah. So it's just like a little bit of a Sunday stretch going out and about, just a little bit headed out, and it's gonna be headed back home now, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in today, and I'll see you guys next time.